In this tutorial, we will create a postcard in Photoshop and practice using the type tool. I already have a file of tulips open. You can find this practice file in the description below. To create our postcard, go to File, New. We are going to use one of the presets in Photoshop for a postcard. So go to the Art and Illustration tab, click Postcard, and the size and dimensions are already set up for you for a postcard. We are going to do a horizontal postcard, so change the orientation to horizontal. Click Create. Now let's go ahead and save our file. So go to File, Save As, and click Save once you've named your file. Navigate to the tab with your flower image. We are going to use the Move tool to click and drag this image into our postcard file. With the tulip image open and the Move tool selected, click inside the image and click and hold and drag your cursor to our postcard tab. Continue to hold and then release your mouse to drop the image into our postcard. Next thing we want to do, we actually want to turn this image on its side so the flowers are on the right side, not on the bottom. We need to zoom out of our artboard so we can see it a little better. So I'm going to use the zoom tool on the left, and you can zoom in or out using these little zoom tool selections at the top of the screen. So I'm going to use the zoom out option and then click on my artboard a couple times. Next, we want to rotate our image. So go to Edit, Transform, Rotate. And you should see a bounding box around the image, which goes off the artboard. So if you get close to the edges, you should see a little rotate tool. Click and hold the Shift key and rotate your image 90 degrees. And then we want to move our image to the far right so our tulips are on the right side of our postcard. Click Enter. I'm now going to zoom back into my artboard so we can start adding text. You can also zoom in and out with some keyboard shortcuts. On a Mac, Command plus and minus. On a PC, it's Control plus and minus. Let's add a headline. So I'm going to use the Type tool. It's in the left toolbar in Photoshop. And first thing I'm going to do is just click onto my artboard with the Type tool. We are going to give this postcard a headline. Springtime Tulip Sale. We want to style this type and make it much larger because it is our main headline for this postcard. Let's select our text and make adjustments. With the Type tool selected, click on your text and you can click and drag over it to select it. Let's open our character panel to make adjustments to the size, color, and fonts. So go to Window, Character, and a little pop-up should appear on the right. First thing we should do, let's make this type a little bit bigger so we can see it a little bit larger in a headline size. So I'm going to adjust the font size here. There's a drop-down on the right so you can select a size. You can also type a size in if these sizes aren't large enough. You can also hover over this little T here and you should see some arrows and you can slide right and left to adjust your type size with a slider. I'm going to make my type quite large. I actually want to make this two lines. So put your cursor in front of the word tulip and hit return. So springtime and then tulip sale. They should be on two lines now. Let's change our font. So if you select your type again, with the character panel open, let's click this little drop down for our font. I'm looking for a serif font. I think that would match the vibe that I'm going for in this postcard a little bit better. I'm going to use Garamond Premiere Pro on my machine, but you can use any font you want. I'm going to make this type even larger so it fills the space just a little bit better. I'm going to adjust the leading. The leading is right over next to the type size. And I'm going to just tighten this headline up a little bit so the words are a little closer. And then last thing I want to do, I want to make this headline a beautiful color and I want it to match a color that's in my tulips. So select your text in the character box, select this little color option and just click the swatch there, and you should get a color picker pop-up. So what you want to do, you want to hover over the image and you should see this little color picker icon appear. I'm going to just click into these tulips, click around, and it is selecting colors in this image. So I'm going to find a color that I like that is high contrast, and this one looks pretty good. So now that I've chosen my color for my headline, click OK. Let's move on to some detail text. So with the type tool selected again, click into your artboard, and you should see some lorem ipsum pop up. It is using the same type style that we just made for our headline. This is going to be a subhead, so I don't want it to be the same size and color. I want it to be smaller. So first thing I'm going to make this type much smaller. Let's replace the text. So this tulip sale is going to take place at the plant nursery. Hit return on Saturday, May 3rd. Okay, let's adjust this text a little more. Select the text. I'm going to adjust my leading again. This text is way too far apart. And I don't actually want this text to be pink. I want it to be, I'm going to use the color picker again, and I'm just going to use a medium to dark gray. Slide your cursor around in this box until you find a color that you like. You can also find colors using this slider over here. Click OK. I'm going to make this text a little smaller. Last thing I'm going to make this text all caps. So select it again in your character panel box, click the little hamburger menu, and select all caps. I'm going to make it a little smaller again and adjust my leading. And with the move tool selected, you can move it up a little bit to be closer to the headline. Okay, last thing I'm going to add a little paragraph of text at the bottom. So with the type tool selected again, this time I want you to click and drag a box. And if you release your mouse, it will populate it with lorem ipsum text. And we're just going to use lorem ipsum for this detail paragraph. First thing, I don't want my paragraph to be all caps. So I'm going to turn all caps off. I'm going to make this type much smaller. So it's paragraph text. And actually, I don't want to use Garamond on this. I want to use a sans serif font. So I'm going to select Arial and then continue to adjust my leading. You may have to adjust how much lorem ipsum you have in this paragraph by deleting a line or two. You can also adjust the size of this paragraph, the width, with this little slider. And then I am going to also add a call to action. So a URL at the end. I'm going to say tulipsale.com. Select that text. I'm going to make this bold instead of regular Arial, so it stands out just a little bit more. Let's take a look at our postcard. A couple small adjustments I want to make before I'm finished. I'm going to make sure that all my text is aligned on the left here. It looks a little bit staggered. So you can do that by using the ruler and dragging a guide over. So you just click into the ruler and drag a guide and drop it. If you don't see your ruler or the guides, go to View, Rulers, and Show Guides in your View menu. So a guide will help me align all of these paragraphs of text. And I'm just selecting each one using the Move tool. And then last thing I want to adjust the spacing between each section of text. I'm going to move my subhead away from my headline just a little bit and visually group it with the paragraph below. I'm going to move this headline down just a hair. And if you want to look at your final design without the guide, go to View, show guides and just turn your guides off. Last thing we want to do is go to File, Save. So that's how you create a postcard in Photoshop using the Type tool. Subscribe to Crye Studio for more graphic design tutorials in Photoshop. Thanks so much.